In today's video, I'll be talking about the permanent mandibular first premolars. The permanent mandibular first premolar is the fourth tooth from the midline in the mandibular arch. This is the mandibular right first premolar. I don't have the mandibular left first premolar. According to the universal numbering system, this is tooth number 28 and mandibular left first premolar is tooth number 21. The buccal aspect is similar to the canine and the second premolar. It is convex, both occlusal cervically and mesiodistally. The mesial margin is concave, while the distal margin is also concave, but it is slightly shorter. The cervical margin curves evenly towards the root apex. The buccal cusp tip divides the occlusal outline into two portions, the mesio-occlusal and disto-occlusal slopes. The buccal cusp is slightly towards the mesial side, as a result of which the mesio-occlusal slope is shorter than the disto-occlusal slope. The buccal ridge is the most prominent portion of the buccal surface. Mesiobuccal and distobuccal developmental depressions are present, imbrication lines are normally absent, and the buccal height of contour is located in the cervical third. Coming to the lingual aspect, it is convex in all directions. As the crown is lingually inclined and the lingual cusp is shorter than the buccal cusp, the buccal half of the occlusal table is visible from the lingual aspect. The proximal margins are the same as that of the buccal cusp, except that they are shorter. The cervical margin is slightly convex towards the root apex. The lingual cusp is short but may be sharp, and it is dividing the occlusal outline into two portions, the mesio-occlusal and disto-occlusal slopes. The lingual cusp is slightly towards the mesial surface, as a result of which the mesio-occlusal slope is shorter than the disto-occlusal slope. The lingual height of contour is located in the middle third. One of the landmark features of this tooth is the mesiolingual developmental groove. This will be discussed later. The mesial margin is roughly rhomboidal in shape, the buccal margin is convex, while the lingual margin is less convex and is shorter when compared with the buccal margin. The cervical margin is slightly curved towards the occlusal surface. On the occlusal surface, the buccal portion of the transverse ridge is sloping at a 45 degree angle. This is paralleled by the mesial marginal ridge. The mesiolingual developmental groove is visible. The contact area is circular to somewhat ovoid in shape, and it is located towards the buccal surface in the middle third. The height of contour is also located here. The distal aspect is similar to the mesial aspect, except that there is no distolingual developmental groove. The distal surface is shorter occluso-cervically and wider buccolingually when compared with the mesial surface. The cervical line is less curved towards the occlusal surface. The contact area is similar in shape and location, but it occupies a slightly broader area. The distal marginal ridge is not as steep when compared with the mesial marginal ridge. The occlusal aspect is diamond-shaped. There's a notch on the mesial surface due to the presence of the mesiolingual developmental groove. As the buccal and lingual cusps are towards the mesial surface, the distal portion of the occlusal surface is larger than the mesial portion. The buccal and lingual margins are convex. The mesial margin is slightly convex to nearly straight, while the distal margin is convex. The occlusal aspect is bounded by the mesial and distal marginal ridges and the cusp ridges of the buccal and lingual cusps. Now, coming to the components of the occlusal table, we are going to talk about the buccal cusp, the lingual cusp, transverse ridge, marginal ridges, fossa, pits, and grooves. Starting with the buccal cusp, it is slightly towards the mesial surface and it is located towards the buccal portion of the occlusal surface. As the crown is lingually inclined, the buccal cusp is also located approximately over the long axis of the tooth. The cusp has four cusp ridges, the mesial cusp ridge, distal cusp ridge, lingual cusp ridge, and buccal cusp ridge. It also has four inclined planes, mesiobuccal inclined plane, distobuccal inclined plane, mesiolingual inclined plane, and distolingual inclined plane. All four of the inclined planes are functional. The lingual cusp is shorter than the buccal cusp and it is also towards the mesial surface. It also has four cusp ridges and four inclined planes, which are named exactly like the buccal cusp. As the lingual cusp itself is non-functional, all of the inclined planes are non-functional. Just like in the maxillary premolar, the triangular ridge of the buccal cusp and the lingual cusp combine to form the transverse ridge. The mesial marginal ridge slopes from the buccal to lingual at a 45 degree angle, while the distal marginal ridge is longer, more prominent, and not as steep when compared with the mesial marginal ridge. On the occlusal surface, there are two irregular depressions, the mesial and distal fossa. The mesial fossa is linear in shape, while the distal fossa is larger and roughly circular in shape. The mesial fossa is bounded by the mesial marginal ridge, transverse ridge, and mesial cusp ridges of the two cusps, while the distal fossa is bounded by the distal marginal ridge, the transverse ridge, and distal cusp ridges of the two cusps. The deepest portion of the fossa is called the pit. This is the mesial pit, and this is the distal pit. The mesial pit is the point of union of three primary grooves, while the distal pit is the point of union of four primary grooves. Coming to the grooves, this is the central groove, This is the mesiobuccal triangular groove and this is the mesiolingual triangular groove. On the distal side, this is the distal lingual triangular groove, this is the distal marginal groove, and this is the distal buccal triangular groove. The root is single, straight, and has a sharp apex. The length of the root is slightly less than that of the mandibular second premolar. The root is wider buccolingually than it is mesiodistally. The buccal and lingual surfaces are convex, while the mesial and distal surfaces are slightly convex to flat. The midroot section is ovoid in shape, and it is wider buccolingually than it is mesiodistally. Coming to the variations and anomalies, there are a lot of variations in the crown. These include the absence of mesiolingual developmental groove, two parallel mesiolingual developmental grooves. The lingual cusp size varies. It may be absent or may be nearly as large as the buccal cusp. The lingual cusp can be centered mesiodistally or offset to the distal. Normally it is towards the mesial. There are a lot of variations in the continuity of the transverse ridge. This is affected by the depth of the central groove. The root may display a bifurcation and create buccal and lingual root branches.